I'm here in Dallas for REITWorld 2011, NAREIT's annual convention for all things REIT. Joining me is Mary Hogan, Managing Director with APG Asset Management US. Mary, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Great. Over the last few years, how would you say that investors' attitudes and their opinions of REITs have changed?
I think that, especially looking over sort of the last 3 to 4 years, I think that the volatility, which has been a huge issue and a concern for investors, I think people are getting a little bit more comfortable with REITs as a proxy for real estate and what that volatility means. Because even though in the short term, you know, intraday, intraweek, even a 12-month period, the moves can be startling. We've been kind of in this volatile phase for long enough. I do think that over the longer run, the returns remain very good and still somewhat like real estate. And so I think that is getting people more comfortable again with using REITs as a proxy for real estate.
And now as we head into 2012, what are some of the big issues that the industry is facing?
I think there's three big issues. The global picture, the access to capital. Is this going to be Great Financial Crisis 2.0? I think that's going to be something that's going to affect REITs, and you will start to hear about the haves versus the have-nots again in terms of access to capital. I think the second thing, of course, is the American economy. Heading into the election, is anything going to get done? Or should people be retrading sectors that have done well, or should they just stick with what's worked? I think one particular thing that REIT investors have to think about also is Washington, D.C. specifically. If you look at the largest companies across all sectors, a lot of them have huge exposure to the metropolitan Washington, D.C. region. And I think there's a lot of concern about a shrinking government and what that could mean. I mean, I have to say, I haven't yet seen the government shrink in my 20 years at this, and so I think that even for the government to shrink, you have to hire consultants to help you shrink. And so I don't think it's going to be necessarily as bad as people think it is ultimately, but it's something that we have to watch closely.
And are there any sectors that perhaps you're a little more favorable on than the overall general consensus?
Well, given the nature of our clients, I think we can take a little bit more of a long-term view. And when I think about it that way, I continue to get excited about the healthcare real estate sector. I think the transactions you saw in the beginning of this year were so exciting, and I think that the REITs have really only tapped the surface of the opportunity of buying assets from the operators in one area of the economy that people have to agree is going to be expanding. I definitely think we're vulnerable to short-term headwinds, even very short-term headwinds, when we hear from the super committee what they're going to say. But I do think if you can take a long view, I think the acquisition opportunities available to the healthcare REITs are really impressive.
Mary, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
For more from REITWorld 2011, be sure to visit REIT.com.